Inspector Ken.
Because as long as Mr. Frankenstein lives, our village is in danger.
Oh! What, Inspector? The Baron is dead, and that's the last of the Frankenstein.
Yeah.
One lives.
Oh!
A grandson.
Who is he?
What does he do?
He is a professor of the Dean of Anatomy at New York's famous Institute of Tangle Learning, the Johns Miriam, the Johns Miriam Anthony Hopkins School of Medicine.
Oh!
Shot as long as he lives. As long as this young Frankenstein walks the earth, he will never be safe.
Yeah. Ooh, Inspector! When the Frankensteins are so dangerous!
You're telling me! I'll never forget when I was a young man as he was walking. One of the Frankenstein's creatures came rampaging through our village. I tried to stop him, but I couldn't. He tore off my leg! And my right arm.
Oh.
I had to go all the way to Vienna just to find a top surgeon who could put me back together again.
Oh, a top surgeon in Vienna? That must have been expensive.
Expensive? Ooh. Are you kidding me? It cost me an arm and a leg.
Oh.
Which cost more? The arm? Or the leg?
Oh.
We have to get a new village, idiot!
Yeah.
Beware.
I'm right.
Wait. Beware. Crap bubbles. Beware of Frankenstein.
I might be the village idiot, but I ask you, what are the chances of a New York doctor ever coming to Transylvania?
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. No more Frankenstein!
You can say it again!
No more Frankenstein!
We're the happiest town in the
Okay.
I've never spoken with nor given instruction to, has great generously donated his time for today's lecture.
I'm not sure I understand the difference between reflexive and voluntary impulses.
Well, that's wonderful because today's lecture focuses on those exact topics.
His goal of a tells us reason that he's not a sentient impulse full of thought to create a lot of pain.
Mr. Hilltop, will you raise your left knee, please?
Write it down, write it down.
Just witnessed a voluntary reflex.
Mr. Hilltop, you're alone with your name.
No, you're okay.
You got to go. Down to the down.
So if you don't, like when you didn't start because he wasn't there, I understand, you can't stop the tape.
No, I am well aware of that.
I know. So you have to just jump right back. Just keep it still. Mr. Hilltop, even if you call him six times and he comes out, ignore the rest of the lines and just keep going. But now I can't really go back because I don't really know where it is. So let's do it without the music. But what if we need to block? Because I don't know where it is now. So what
if we were to block these impulses, which we can do with simple pressure with any ordinary clamp at the base of the posterior nerve root for say 4 seconds. Why, you miserable son of...
Oh. No, see? Girls don't make the sound. Girls don't have balls. Keep going.
Even though I need him in the crotch, he feels absolutely nothing.
More or less. So, without these impulses going from the brain, we would collapse like a bunch of broccoli. And in conclusion, so there's no confusion, let me say it once again. Though your genitalia has been known to failure, you can bet your ass on the brain.
No, I'm telling parents.
Everybody!
The brain!
Call me a Darwin, all of that man's theory. Call me Pasteur and watch me get theory. Say man of Curie, that would be best. Call me a Rorschach, I'm up to the test. I really light up when you call me Edison. Call me an Ehrlich, I love that man's medicine. Call me a Marconi, that wireless wow. Call me Pavlov and I'll bark like a child. Woo! Call me an Einstein, it's all very fine. Call me a Tesla, I wouldn't decline. But to call me a Frankenstein would be insane. Cause I love the
going
back to what I cut out.
Class dismissed, go.
I'm sorry,
sir. No, listen, it's not good.
That's Frankenstein.
If you say so, it's from overseas, Transylvania Heights.
Can't talk backstage, we hear you.
Transylvania Heights? Who do I know in Transylvania Heights? Oh, could you read it, please?
I regret to inform you that your grandfather, Dr. Victor von Frankenstein, has passed away and died.
Oh, no!
Oh, yes. Need to come to his castle at once.
Oh no!
Oh yes. It is important that you come to his castle at once, or your entire estate will be seized by the Transylvania tax authorities.
Oh no!
Oh yes.
Thank you. Here's a dime.
Oh no, this will never be wasted.
Oh,
yes,
no.
Cross the blood, I could literally cross her.
Thank you. Here's a dime.
I go back.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Goodbye, Dr. Frankenstein.
That's Frankenstein!
And then blackout, and Richard comes out with the.
Oh no.
Richard comes out with the suitcase.
Right.
And when do I
what am I doing? With a chair.
My luggage.
I don't have the luggage.
No, pretend.
Okay.
Just bring my luggage out.
From the other side.
From
the
same
side.
Same
side as me?
This is a scene change. It's not really that way.
Mm.
Then you go back.
Not very late for this trip.
Then the lights come on.
I understand. I'm sorry.
Thank you, darling. Hey, you.
Hey.
I hope somebody likes old-fashioned weddings.
I prefer old-fashioned wedding nights.
Oh, you're just incorrigible. Oh, the hair, darling, the hair. I just had it done. I've been Marcel for 6 hours by Marcel himself.
I'm sorry. I promise I'll pick us up. I can dream. Can't I?
Yes, for me, science has always come first.
Yes.
Absolutely, well, you can do it.
Elizabeth! Transylvania Station?
Yeah, track 29. Then I give you a sign?
No thanks, I'm wearing suede.
Oh, suede. Who the hell invented this fantastic suede?
What's that? Dr. Frankenstein
startled me. That's Frankenstein.
Oh, you pulled my leg.
No, not.
Oh, you're not. Then your first name, you pronounce it Froderick?
Frederick.
Why isn't your name Froderick Frankenstein?
Because it isn't.
As you wish, Master.
Master? Then you must be Igor.
No. You pronounce it Igor.
They told me it was Igor.
Well, they were wrong then, weren't they? Did you know, Master, that my grandfather used to work for yours?
That's very nice.
And it's always been my dream, ever since I was little. One day I would work for you, just as my grandfather used to work for yours. Of course, the rates have come up.
Of course.
It's been such a pleasure to work for you, Master. We could open up the old laboratory. We could reconnect the voltmeters and dust off the lightning rods. And then one day, when everything is all nice and set up in our laboratory so nicely, we'll go down to the graveyard at midnight. Dig ourselves up a nice big fresh corpse.
I would.
Thing we'll do. Just like the olden times, you and me, right up there with the world's greatest pairs. Right up there with the world's greatest pairs. Like Laurel and Hardy, like Hope and Ricardi, like Juliet, Romeo and Benfro, to and fro, together, together again.
Remember that our curse.
to see. We've got to agree. We're just going to be everywhere. All of my life, I am lost in the rain. Needed a Lord like a spoon. All of my life, I've been walking around. But what good is a lost if we ain't got a spoon?
I don't mean to embarrass you, but I am rather brilliant surgeon. I can do something about that at home.
What? On a series of historic experiments which will do so many things for humanity. I was waiting for him to...
Thank you. My dear Ivor, how many times do I have to tell you I have no interest in carrying on my grandfather's wacky work?
Really? Then I suppose I lost my money when I hired a... give me the line. Give me the line.
I went so far as to
hire a local girl, Eva, to help you with your wacky work.
Well, you had no need to do that because I have absolutely no use for...
Hello!
And this is Inga, the girl.
How do you do, Doctor?
How do you do?
I have a master's degree in laboratory science from Heidelberg Junior College. I can fulfill all your needs. I'm a very hard worker, and if necessary, I can even bend over backwards for you.
What do you say, Doc? Should I fire her?
Well, I'd like to sleep. I mean, think about it.
Well, by the way, how are we getting to the castle?
Wie Strafer, die Schlagen, Wagen, Tutschen, Frutschen.
What's that?
A hayride!
And up and down, 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 and up and down welcome, Master, to Castle Frankenstein. I'll check to see if the
will do the one
her eyes
on Sunnybrook Farm.
Thank you. outside.
Oh, family business. Gotta join it, because I'm a Frankenstein. But I'm not a Frankenstein. I don't want to join. I don't want to.
If you don't stop talking, I'm gonna cut things. I asked very nicely 16 times. When you get off the stage, you can't talk. If you can't hold it in, go all the way outside in the back. You stand behind the screen, everybody can hear you. Thank you. It was a dream, whatever you said.
I don't want to join. I'm a Frankenstein, but I don't want to be a Frankenstein.
Doctor, wake up. You are having a nightmare.
A nightmare? Yeah, yes, I was. My ancestors, they're all crazy.
Can you put the screen up, Phil?
Yeah, thank you.
But boy, could they dance. Where is that music coming from? It sounds like it's coming from behind that wall. I'm gonna go see where it's coming from.
And take a look.
I'm gonna go take a look.
Doctor, let me convince you. I'm afraid to stay here alone.
Then close your room and follow me.
That's it.
Just a rat. A dirty, filthy, disgusting rat.
Oh, thank goodness.
Good Lord, where the devil are we?
Good Lord, where the devil are we?
I got nobody.
Igor. I heard the music. I was upstairs and I came down to check it out.
So it wasn't you playing that violin?
Oh no, I only played the French horn.
So there must have been somebody else here playing that violin.
You're right, Chris.
Aren't there any lights in here?
Well, there is a nasty looking switch over here. But, Master, there's a big chance of instant electrocution. We try it.
Here goes nothing. Ah. So this is it. My grandfather's laboratory. What an frightful mess.
Oh, hello. What happened? Well, you're supposed to say about drapes and...
You can't put your body upstate. Move that chair down, somebody, and pretend like the table's there, but don't ever turn around. And you have to cross all the way past the table, and that's when you see it. That's why it never works.
So he has to say it.
Oh, I don't know. Some drapes, a little...
No, yes, you're right, but you have to cross on... He can't go to you. Look, so what is this? This is where it all happened. My grandfather's laboratory.
What a filthy mess.
Historic settings. Legendary experience.
What a filthy mess.
Oh, I don't know. A couple of drapes and changes of paint and some paintings will be fine.
Oh, hello. What have we here? So this must be where the music's for the violin.
It's still warm.
And that cigar is still smoldering in that ashtray. Someone or something must have been down here.
Here she comes.
Frau Bunker.
I am that someone or something.
No, the line is Frau Bunker. You see her?
Frau Bunker.
music.
That music. You were playing that music.
Yes, music that reaches the soul when words are useless. Your grandfather used to play that exact same tune to soothe the creatures we crave.
And that's your cigar. It's still smoldering in the ashtray.
Yep. And you led,
and you played it to lead us down here.
Yes.
And that is your cigar still in the ashtray.
Yes.
So you and Victor were not just housekeeper. You were not just his housekeeper.
Yes.
So you and Victor were.
Yes.
He was my boyfriend.
He was your boyfriend.
Yes.
And then the song. The song is over. She's not here.
Yep. She's not here.
He was my boyfriend. Yes.
Here, Victor's book. Read it, and you'll see how the dead can be brought back to life. You're going to just exile.
How I did it.
Now, please, you don't really think I can actually. That's a lie, you guys. Please, you don't really think that anyone could actually.
Okay. Please, you don't really think anyone could bring the
thing. I know. I saw it with my own eyes. And it's all there in Victor's book. Here, sit.
How I Did It, by Dr. Victor Frankenstein. After years of study, I felt that I could bring dead tissue back to life. Preposterous. Hold on a second here. Changing the world.
His hands, his feet, his organs must all be
popular.
So.
Yes.
We need to find a corpse, newly dead, 7 feet tall, with all its organs intact.
Can't come on during the scene.
Trust me, Master. Trust in me.
Blackout. Blackout. Now you guys come on. Lights up.
I can feel it in my bones. There's something going on in that castle.
And the thing at the same time, because I only have 2 hands.
Kilko,
this one will be no music.
Oh.
Maybe I'll put it on.
Oh.
I can stop it and then put it back on. Okay.
The laboratory redux is funny because it kind of goes with Ivor's theme.
As we normal.
Yeah.
Right.
Okay. It says it, but it's not here. It's supposed to be after. Done that yet. That's why. So this is the music when you enter. Now come in with the brain.
Oh, no, you're coming.
Coming into the laboratory with the brain.
Oh, I thought she was about to see you. Okay.
You are. No, I'm saying with your head. Never mind. Okay. You're right.
There! His brilliant new brain is now in place.
How's that, boss?
Wasn't your mom on this side?
Wow!
The hump wasn't on the right side?
Well, the Wasn't it on the right side?
Never mind.
It's his line.
His line.
Oh, never mind.
Never mind. Well, you said that.
So now let us proceed.
Here stations.
No, except one of the most daring radicals of medical history. The storm is directly over us. You must hurry to your station.
To your stations.
Yes, Master.
Yes, Master.
Generator.
Igor, turn on the generator.
Yes, Master. Generator on.
Now release the switch on the main valve.
Yes, Master. Releasing.
Oh, Victor, we're doing it!
Lord?
No.
I'll cue you.
Now we hurl the gauntlet of science into the frightful face of death itself.
That's my fault because it didn't play what it's supposed to play, but that's okay.
The storm and strife, fade, fade, give my creature life. Tear the night asunder, cast your light upon the dark. The lightning bolt is gone, the world is night.
Nothing.
Sorry, Master.
Not a spark. I failed. Utterly failed.
Sorry, Master.
I don't get it. It always worked for Victor, and he couldn't even see.
Oh, Doctor, I feel so bad for you.
No. Be of good cheer. If science teaches us anything, it's for us to accept our failures and our successes with a quiet dignity and grace. You rotten, no good bastard! How could you do
this? No, stop it! You'll kill him!
How could you do this to me? I don't want to live!
Quiet dignity and grace, huh?
like that. We're your friends. Would you like us to set you free? We're going to set him free.
No, you're not. Stand back and hold the police stand back. Hello there. Don't worry. We're your friends. Set him free.
Is this a set him free?
Yes, don't.
Would you like us to set you free? Okay, we're going to set you free.
I don't know.
Now,
I'm not nervous about this. Why
now,
I'm nervous
now
about
sit
that?
Up.
I'm not nervous. Not me.
Sit up. Very good. Now stand. I know you can do it. Don't try to kid a kidder. Very good. Very good. Now walk.
Oh, Doctor, I'm so frightened.
Frightened? I'm terrified.
Not me. Is that good times? Nope.
Good.
Good.
That's good. Very good.
That's good. Very good. That's very good. Very good point.
No, I'm not nervous about this.
No.
Quinn. Well, he's not attacking. He's up.
What is it? What's wrong?
Give him the sedative. Was that the brain of Hans Delbert, the scholar and the saint?
Well,
not exactly.
You see, I had the brain and then it fell splat on the floor. So I had to get another one. But this one was much better. The old brain was too small. It had ridges on it. Yeah, the new brain is much bigger. It's smooth, no ridges, no wrinkles at all.
Now we're getting somewhere. And whose brain did you bring me?
Are you going to get angry if I tell you?
I will not get angry.
Well, Abby, somebody.
Abby, somebody. Abby, who?
Abby Normal.
Abby Normal. You mean to tell me that you put an abnormal brain into a 7-foot-tall, 4-foot-wide gorilla? Is that what you're telling me?
Hey, get the monster!
Hey. What's that?
Wait, someone at the front door.
It must be the villager. Don't look upstage and then be looking that way. That was just the monster.
What was that?
I didn't hear anything.
This time I definitely heard something.
No, you didn't.
Nope, you turn around. Igor.
It's me.
The monster's awake.
The monster's awake. You've got to create a diversion fast.
Now get up,
29. You have to, Eva, when you say your line, it's really funny, but you keep doing this, and then nobody's going to see. So, yes, you. When you walk out, just walk, if that's the curtain line, just come out and say, what is your line, your first line?